Well, here we are this morning, Saturday morning, race morning at Goulburn's Wakefield Park. The Catavolt entry team is here and it's going to be cold. It showed -6 on the computer this morning. The best news is though, it's a beautiful clear day and it should warm up to give us some good track temperature by the time we get out there.
Hi, this is Al Bunsu, also known as Crazy Al from electriccarconversionblog.com.
I'm fascinated by them actually. I really like the idea that people are having to work things out as they go along. It's all so new and everyone seems to have a different idea about how they should approach it. And you've got one, for example, the hub motor in the back wheel. I believe some of them are running DC motors, some of them are running AC motors.
Well, I think it's got a lot of promise. It's definitely interesting. I'm certainly intrigued. I'd like to have a go on one.
Notice the second one had a bit of a whine, a bit of a turbo sort of a sound to it. And I was just really wondering if there was a difference in the two, so that got us talking, so we're interested in them.
Well, that was qualifying one. That went pretty good for us. We were worried about our bike overheating, and so what we wanted to do was a race simulation, try and do 6 laps in the qualifier. We got that done and it didn't cut out, so that's fantastic. In the process, we were able to set a new qualifying lap record, 1:15.3, and the previous was my lap record of 1:17.2.
The tube has been pinched that was doing our water cooling, so we're just correcting that. Long before lithium batteries were on the scene, I just always thought it would be a better option because of the power of electric motors. I worked with electric motors at the time. I was always dreaming up ways to use them. Electric motorcycles seemed like the best idea.
This racing's at the early stages, so it's all about technical innovation. If you can do something better than the other guy, you're going to get the upper hand.
Last time we dynoed it was straight after a race, so now it's got a full charge. It's only sitting at 42% power at the moment, so we'll see what it does.
Really light throttle, up to as fast as you can go and then crack it.
It's so different from what we see with, you know, the normal formulas of motorbikes or cars, where they try to make every bike exactly the same. They're then rider competitions. This is great because it's still a technology competition.
You can see there's a big difference between the R1 to this bike here. You can see initially the power is at 40 horsepower and basically you're sustaining it the whole way through. But this one is about 30 horsepower then building up to it.
The controller is now ramping amps up so that it just doesn't trip out.
Oh, okay. Yep.
And I'd rather get rid of the trip out function altogether and just dump all this amperage into there. It'd be a short circuit basically.
Yeah, yeah.
I'd rather have that. I'm going to talk to Kelly.
There's nothing better than having two bikes actually racing each other close, neck for neck, and hearing them go past. There's no roar, but that sound is brilliant. Just that whole whoosh, and you know that that's all from the speed.
The initiative being shown by the Electric Championship is fantastic. For example, here at Wakefield Park this weekend, 15 seconds less time on a lap in less than 12 months. It just epitomises the development and the commitment to, I guess, the way of the future.
What was the lap time?
Consistent 14s.
Jason did a consistent 1:14 throughout the whole race. Actually did a 1:19 in his first lap, which is last year's lap record.
Yeah, my chassis is running absolutely perfectly. It's railing around corners. I've never ridden this fast in my life, pretty much. We've got great tyres, great suspension, really light package. The bike's gone back and forth, and it's changed shape and changed configuration, and I'm really figuring out what actually works and what doesn't work. In the end, you know, we're going to be able to write down what works and what doesn't work, and it's going to be a lot simpler for other people just to say, oh yeah, we'll get one of those, we'll get one of those, and bolt it into the bike and go racing.
Well, this is my first time I've ever seen an electric superbike in action. Freaking hell, it goes. Why not use the power that's landing on us right now for free? Zero emissions and we can still have fun.
Both of them set lap records this race. Daniel held it for a whole lap before Jason took it back off him. Brilliant race, really.
So that was great, Sunday's race. Happy to say we won it and won the championship in the process as well for 2012.
It's going straight up from here. We're just going to get faster and faster. We'll end up chewing at the heels of the Super Motards and the GP450s first, and then after that,
probably start tackling the 600s, I reckon.
The technology's there in America and Europe. They've just got massive budgets to get the speed that they need to. And when they've got bikes that are 10 seconds off MotoGP times, then obviously that's going to be around what a 600 is. So, yeah, 5 years from now, it's possible.
This is Crazy Al signing off for the TTXGP eFXC Australian Championship.